If you like the video, please subscribe Technical PCT channel and click the bell icon to get the latest videos.
Good morning. So in the last class, the structural isomerism, in structural isomerism, chain isomerism and position isomerism is completed. So alkyl halides can exhibit chain isomerism and position isomerism. To exhibit chain isomerism, so alkyl group contains minimum 4 carbon atoms. So N-butyl chloride and isobutyl chloride are chain isomers. Whereas, so N-propyl chloride and isopropyl chloride are position isomers. So change in the position of chlorine from first position to second position. So N-butyl chloride, all the 4 carbon atoms are in straight chain. So CH2 Cl, it is N-butyl chloride. So IUPAC name is, so it is N-butyl chloride. IUPAC name is 1-chlorobutane. Next, the second one is the isobutyl chloride. It is isoform. It is a CH2. It is a Cl. So common name is, it is isobutyl chloride. So IUPAC name, it is the longest chain, first carbon, second carbon, third carbon. So 1-chloro-2-methyl-propane, 1-chloro, no change in the position of substituent. But what is the difference? Change in the arrangement of carbon atoms in carbon chain. So N-butyl chloride and isobutyl chlorides are chain isomers. Whereas N-propyl chloride, so N-propyl chloride. So CH3, it is CH2. Next it is CH2. Cl, it is N-propyl chloride. So what is the IUPAC name? 1-chloro. Root wall is prop, carbon-carbon containing single bond. So 1-chloropropane. Next, the second one is isopropyl chloride, CH3. CH, it is CH3. It is Cl. Or it is also considered as CH3. CH, it is Cl, it is CH3. This CH is attached with 2 CH3 groups. So it is iso, total number of carbon atoms is 3. So isopropyl chloride. So common name is isopropyl chloride. So isopropyl chloride, what is the IUPAC name? It is the first carbon, it is the second carbon, it is the third carbon. Or it is the first carbon, it is the second carbon, it is the third carbon. So 2-chloro. Root wall is prop, carbon-carbon containing single bond. It is 1-chloropropane, it is 2-chloropropane. So what is the difference? Change in the position of chlorine substituent from first carbon to second carbon. So it is 1-chloropropane, it is 2-chloropropane. Common name is N-propyl chloride. It is isopropyl chloride. So N-propyl chloride and isopropyl chlorides are position isomers. Whereas N-butyl chloride and isobutyl chlorides are chain isomers because of difference in the arrangement of carbon atoms in the carbon chain. The next one is in stereoisomerism. Stereoisomerism is of two types, geometrical isomerism and the second one is the optical isomerism. So this geometrical isomerism and optical isomerism, I will explain later. So after the completion of ethyl chloride preparation, properties and uses. The next one, substitution SN1 reaction, SN2 reaction. Before going to the SN1, SN2 reaction, so I will cover the stereoisomerism. Okay, right. Next two, methods of preparations of ethyl chloride. Methods of preparations of ethyl chloride. So what is the formula of ethyl chloride? C2H5Cl, ethyl chloride. Okay, so these are ethyl chloride or propyl chloride, these are all alkyl halides. So what is the formula of alkyl halide? Rx. Here what is X? Here X is either F, Cl, Br or I. Okay, so what is the nature of bonding? Example, you take a methyl chloride, CH3. It is Cl, means halogen. So it is methyl halide. So halogens are more electronegative than carbon. So electronegativity of fluorine, highest electronegativity for fluorine in Pauling scale is value 4. Next to chlorine, 3.0. Next to bromine, nearly 2.8. Iodine, nearly 2.5. Next to carbon, nearly 2.4. These are the electronegativity values. So carbon and halogen means fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine. It is more electronegative. Fluorine is more electronegative than carbon. Even bromine, chlorine, iodine also more electronegative than carbon. Hence, this halogen atom gets a partial negative charge. And the carbon gets a partial positive charge. Okay? So halogen has a partial negative charge. Carbon has a partial positive charge because of high electronegativity of halogen atom than carbon. So halogen attain partial negative charge and carbon attain partial positive charge. Next. So what is the bond length order? What is the bond energy order? And what is the dipole moment order? It is important. So if you take methyl fluoride, CH3F, it is methyl fluoride. Second one is the methyl chloride, CH3Cl. Third one is methyl bromide. Next, the fourth one is methyl iodide. CH3I, methyl iodide. Okay? So, first one, bond length. Bond length. So, CH3F2, CH3Cl, CH3Br, CH3I. So, CX bond length either increases or decreases or remains the same. It is the bond length. So, it is the compound. Next, it is the bond length. Next one is the bond energy. The next one is the dipole moment. Next one is the dipole moment. It is denoted by mu. So its unit is divide. It is denoted by capital D. Okay. So first one CH3F. Second compound is methyl chloride. Next one is the methyl bromide. Next one is the methyl iodide. So methyl fluoride to methyl chloride. So this is CX bond length. It is fluorine. So, fluorine to chlorine, chlorine to bromine, bromine to iodine. So, bromine to iodine, down the group, these are all same group elements. Down the group, size increases. So, as the size increases, bond length increases. So, CF bond length to CCl bond length, CCl bond length to CBr bond length, CBr bond length to CH3I bond length increases. So bond length gradually increases. So what is the correct CX bond length order? What is the correct CX bond length order? So what is the correct bond length order? So CH3F bond length is less than CH3Cl is less than CH3Br is less than CH3I. Okay, so down the group bond length gradually increases. So their value is 1.39. Here CF bond length is 1.39 angstroms. So CCl bond length is nearly 1.78 angstroms. So first one 1.39, second one is 1.78. Next one 1.93. It is 1.93 angstroms. Next, it is approximately 2.04 angstroms. 1.39, 1.78, next 1.93, nearly 2.04 or 2.14 angstroms. Means 1.39, 1.78, 1.93, 2.14 means bond length gradually increases. Okay? So, as the bond length increases, CX bond length, it is the CF bond length. Next, it is the CCl bond length because of chlorine is larger in size than fluorine. Next one, it is the CBr bond length. Chlorine to bromine size increases. Next, bromine to iodine further increases. So, as the size of the halogen atom increases, bond length is also increases. Bond length increases. Next, as the bond length increases, bond energy values increases. So, what is the correct bond energy value? As the bond length increases, nuclear interaction decreases. Hence, bond energy decreases. So second one. So what is the CX bond energy current of the ray? CX bond energy current of the ray. So here, as the bond length increases, bond energy decreases. So here, CH3F, yes, F bond length is greater than CH3CCl bond length is greater than CBr bond energy is greater than CI bond energy. So it is the correct bond energy occur. So CF bond energy is greater than CCl bond energy is greater than CBr bond energy is greater than CI bond energy. Means gradually increases. Okay. So the bond energy of CF bond A, bond energy of CF bond energy of CCl bond energy of CBr. So bond energy of CI. So values are not important. So gradually decreases. So 452. So here bond energy is 452 kilojoules. Here nearly 351 kilojoules. So 452, nearly 350 means bond energy decreases because of bond energy decreases here in kilojoules. So here 293 CBr energy is 293. So here unit is kilojoules per mole. Kilojoules per mole. Next, CI bond length further increases. As the bond length further increases, bond energy further decreases. Here bond energy is nearly 234. So what is the bond energy? 234 kilojoules per mole. Okay. So values are not important. So gradual decreases. 452, 351, 351 to 293, 293 to 234 means bond energy gradually decreases because of bond length increases. Next one, dipole moment. So what is the dipole moment? So dipole moment to mu is equal to delta into L. It is the formula. Dipole moment to mu equal to delta L. It is applicable only for polar molecules. Okay. So delta is the charge, L is the distance between. Here carbon gets a partial negative charge. Suppose we take CX. Halogen gets a partial negative charge. Halogen carbon gets a partial positive charge. So this bond is polar. So we can calculate the dipole moment. Charge into L means bond length. L is the bond length. We know the bond length value is 1.39, 1.78. So it is the bond length. So what is the unit of dipole moment? Deba unit. So 1 deba is equal to, it is denoted by capital D. 1 deba is equal to nearly 10 power minus 18 ESU centimeter. 1 deba is equal to 10 power minus ESU centimeter. So here, take CF bond. Next one is the CCl bond. Next one, second one is the CCl bond. So dipole moment, the third one is the dipole moment. So dipole moment correct order is dipole moment correct order. So it is the CF bond, it is the CCl bond, it is the CBr bond, next it is the CI bond. So it is more polar. So here electronegativity of fluoride is more. So this bond, CF bond, is more polar. More polar. So fluorine to chlorine, chlorine to bromine, bromine to iodine. Electronegativity values gradually decreases. As the electronegativity values decreases, polarity decreases. So what is the correct polarity order of CX bond? What is the correct polarity order? What is the correct polarity order of CX bond? So CF bond is more polar than CCl bond. It is more polar than CBr bond. It is more polar than CI bond. Okay, because the electronegativity is more. Here electronegativity difference is more. So CCl, so fluorine to chlorine electronegativity decreases. Fluorine to bromine, bromine to iodine negativity decreases. Hence polarity decreases. So higher the polarity, higher the polarity. So higher the dipole moment. So theoretically, dipole moment correct order is CF3 polarity is more. So CF3 has a greater dipole moment than CH3Cl, than CH3Br, than CH3I. Means dipole moment values gradually decreases because of polarity decreases. Polarity decreases. But experimentally, the correct order of dipole moments are CH3F, CH3Cl, CH3Br, and CH3I. So what is the correct dipole moment out there? Theoretically, dipole moment is more for methyl fluoride. But experimentally, dipole moment of methyl chloride is slightly more. It is slightly greater than methyl fluoride. Next to methyl bromide. Next to methyl iodide. The mining sequence is the same. It is the exception. So methyl fluoride to theoretical methyl iodide. Dipole moment values gradually decreases, but it is the exception. So why the dipole moment of methyl fluoride is less than methyl chloride? What is the reason? Okay. So here fluorine and chlorine. Fluorine is smaller in size. Fluorine is smaller in size. And CF bond length is very less. So here CH3F means CF bond length is very less. And here smaller size of fluorine. So first reason is smaller size. Smaller size. So any group of first element has abnormal behavior, abnormal properties because of its smaller size, high negativity, absence of d orbital, etc. These are the main reasons. So smaller size and bond length is less. Due to these two reasons, so dipole moment of fluorine, methyl chloride is slightly less than methyl chloride. Okay, no? Slight difference. So the other is so important. So what is the dipole moment value of methyl fluoride? It is nearly 1.847 divides. 1.847 divides. Here it is nearly 1.86 divides. It is 1.847 means almost it is 1.85. It is 1.86. So slightly greater. So dipole moment is slightly greater for methyl chloride than methyl chloride. The next one, methyl chloride to methyl. Methyl chloride to methyl bromide decreases. So here dipole moment value 1.83 divides. Here nearly 1.63 divides means methyl fluoride to methyl chloride dipole moment slightly increases, then decreases to bromide, decreases to iodide. So sequence bond length sequence, bond energy sequence, and dipole moment of the sequence is important. Okay, so note the other update the screenshot. So theoretically, dipole moment is more for CH3F because of here polarity is more. But experimentally, dipole moment of methyl chloride is slightly greater than methyl fluoride. The remaining sequence is the same. Down the group means group of halogen, that is bromide to iodide, dipole moment decreases. Here reason, smaller size of fluorine and bond length is very less. So due to these two reasons, so methyl fluoride has a lower dipole moment than methyl chloride. Okay. So bond length gradually increases. Bond energy decreases. Next, dipole moment also decreases. But dipole moment of methyl chloride is slightly greater than methyl chloride. Next, methods of preparations of alkyl halides. Methods of preparations of alkyl halides. Methyl chloride, CH3, CH2, Cl. So, methods of preparations of methyl chloride and the properties of methyl chloride are important. So, methods of preparations of alkyl halides. First one. So, these alkyl halides are prepared from first method. Alkyl halides are prepared from alcohol. Alkyl halides are prepared from alcohol. Alkyl halides are mainly prepared from alcohols, and the second one from alkanes and alkenes. Alkanes and alkenes. These are the main members. So from alcohol. So what is the formula of alcohol? It is alkyl. What is the functional group of alcohol? OH. So ROH. It is alcohol. So this OH group is replaced by halogen. This OH group is replaced by Cl. Then this minus OH means removal of OH group. Plus X means chlorine, bromine, iodine. So mainly we can prepare alkyl chloride, alkyl bromide, and alkyl iodide. Alkyl chlorides are prepared by separate method because of high reactivity of fluorine. So it is an explosive reaction. So special methods are used in the preparation of fluorides. So in general, we can prepare chlorides, bromides, and iodides easily. That as compared to fluorides. So how to replace the OH group by halogen? So here, so alcohol reacts with hydrogen halides. Hydrogen means H. Halide means X. In the presence of catalyst. This catalyst acts as a dehydrating agent. Here OH and H water is eliminated. So H is substituted on alkyl group. So RX. And what is the byproduct? H2O. Here catalyst acts as a dehydrating agent. It means dehydration. Hydrogen means water. So it removes water. So here ROH is alcohol. So alcohols are classified into three types, we know. Primary alcohols, secondary alcohols, and tertiary alcohols. Like alkyl halides. Alcohols also classified into three types: primary alcohol, secondary alcohol, and tertiary alcohols. Okay? So alcohols are classified into three types. Primary means OH group is attached with the primary carbon are called primary alcohols, like halogens. Halogen atom is attached with the primary carbon. Next, if halogen is attached with the secondary carbon means the carbon which is attached with the two other carbon atoms, it is called the secondary carbon. If halogen is attached, it is the secondary alkyl halide. If OH group is attached with the secondary carbon, it is called a secondary alcohol. Next one is the tertiary alcohol. Tertiary alcohol means OH group is attached with tertiary carbon. What is tertiary carbon? The carbon which is attached with the three other carbon atoms, it is tertiary carbon. If tertiary carbon is attached with the halogen atom, it is a tertiary alkyl halide. If it is attached with OH group, it is called tertiary alcohol. So alcohols are classified into how many types? Three types. Primary alcohols, secondary alcohols, and tertiary alcohol. So it is a primary. It is a secondary. It is. So what correct reactivity order? What is the correct reactivity order of primary, secondary, tertiary alcohols? So what is the correct reactivity order? What is the correct reactivity? What is the correct reactivity of the alcohols with hydrogen halides? What is the correct reactivity of the alcohols with the hydrogen halides? So primary alcohol, secondary alcohol, and tertiary alcohol, which are more reactive. So tertiary alcohols are more reactive than secondary alcohols, than primary alcohols. So tertiary alcohols are more reactive than secondary alcohols, than primary alcohols. Next one, what is the reactivity order of? What is the reactivity order? So what is the reactivity order of hydrogen halides? Hydrogen halides. That is HCl or HF, HCl, HBr, and HI. So what is the correct reactivity of the HF to HCl, HCl to HBr, HBr to HI, reactivity increases. So reactivity is more for hydrogen iodine, because HF to HI size increases, chlorine to chlorine, chlorine to bromine, bromine to iodine increases, size increases. As the size increases, bond length increases. As the bond length increases, bond energy increases. So it can easily ionize H plus and I minus. So reactivity is more for hydrogen iodide than HBr, than HCl, than HR. So what is the correct reactivity of alcohols? Tertiary alcohols are more reactive than secondary alcohols, are more reactive than primary alcohols. Reactive than drop of hydrogen halide. So HX is less reactive than HCl, is less reactive than HBr, is less reactive than HR. Okay? So from alcohols means alcohols reacts with hydrogen halides means with HCl or HBr or HI. In the presence of catalyst, here what is the role of catalyst? Dehydrating agent. What is the role of catalyst? Dehydrating agent. So catalyst acts as dehydrating agent. So in this reaction, the catalyst charge goes. So generally, we use first one, zinc chloride is preferred. Catalyst, either we use zinc chloride or second one, pyridine. Formula C5H5N is the cyclic. Heterocyclic and aromatic compound, heterocyclic and aromatic. So the structure of pyridine, like benzene. So it is the structure of pyridine. It contains nitrogen. Like benzene, it has three pi bonds in alternate positions. Okay, so it is the structure of pyridine. C5H5N. Next, third one, so third one, dimethyl amine is also used. CH3 taken twice NH, this NH group is adopted with two methyl groups. It is example for secondary amines, like alkyl halides, like alcohols. So amines also classified into three types, primary amines, secondary amines, and tertiary amines. So it is the secondary amine because of nitrogen is attached with two alkyl groups, it is the secondary amine. If nitrogen is attached with only one alkyl group, it is a primary. If alkyl group is attached with three alkyl amine group is attached with three alkyl groups, it is a tertiary amine. So first one, zinc chloride is very preferable. Or pyridine also used. Dimethyl amine is also used. Next, fourth one. Concentrated sulfuric acid is also used. H2SO4. Sulfuric acid is also dehydrating agent. Means, what is the role of catalyst? Dehydrating agent. So, what are the mild? These are mild dehydrating agents. It is the strong dehydrating agent. So, zinc chloride is a preferable. So, it is the first method of preparation of alcohol, so alkyl halides from alcohol. So, alcohols treated with hydrogen halides. In the presence of catalysts like zinc chloride or pyridine or dimethyl amine or concentrated sulfuric acid, so gives alkyl halide, and what is the byproduct? Water. So catalyst acts as dehydrating agent. So what is the correct reactivity of alcohols? Tertiary alcohols are more reactive than secondary alcohols, or more reactive than primary alcohols. What is the correct reactivity of hydrogen halides? So as the size of the halogen atom increases, bond length increases. As the bond length increases, bond energy decreases. Hence, HI is more reactive than HBr, is more reactive than HCl, is more reactive than HR. So these two points are very important. Next, catalyst, either zinc chloride or pyridine or dimethyl amine. Methyl groups are two, taken twice, means dimethyl, this amine, or concentrated sulfuric acid is also used as a catalyst, means dehydrating agent. Okay, so take the screenshot. Okay, the next. So specific method. That is the preparation of by this method. How we can prepare ethyl chloride? Ethyl chloride. So to prepare ethyl chloride, we take ethyl alcohol. What is the formula of ethyl alcohol? C2H5, it is ethyl group. Alcohol functional group is OH, so it is ethyl alcohol. Ethyl alcohol. It is the common name. Ethyl alcohol is the common name. So IUPAC name of the compound is ethanol. Suffix is OL, so it is the IUPAC name of ethyl alcohol. So what is the IUPAC name of ethyl alcohol? Ethanol. So in alkane, this is replaced by OL. So suffix for alcohol is OL, it is ethanol. So this ethanol is treated with HCl. In the presence of N-hydrous zinc chloride. N-hydrous zinc chloride. Zinc chloride formula, ZnCl2. So N-hydrous zinc chloride. So what is the formula of N-hydrous zinc chloride? Zinc chloride formula, ZnCl2. So zinc chloride formula, ZnCl2. It acts as a mild dehydrating agent. So here OH and H, water is removed by anhydrous zinc chloride. So it gives ethyl chloride. C2H5Cl, and the water is a byproduct. C2H5Cl is ethyl chloride. Ethyl chloride, it is a common name. So IUPAC name is chloroethane. What is the IUPAC name? Chloroethane. It is a IUPAC. So it is the method of preparation of ethyl chloride. If you take a methyl alcohol, it gives a methyl chloride. So with the HCl in the presence of anhydrous zinc chloride. So ethyl alcohol is a primary alcohol. Ethyl alcohol is a primary alcohol. So if you take a tertiary alcohol, that is a tertiary butyl alcohol, CH3. It is a CH3. It is a CH3. It is a OH. It is the tertiary butyl alcohol, total number of carbons 4. So it is called tertiary butyl alcohol. It is called tertiary butyl alcohol. So this tertiary butyl alcohol reacts with HCl, gives tertiary butyl chloride CH3. Next it is a CH3. Next it is a CH3. Next it is a Cl. So here no need of anhydrous zinc chloride. It is no need of zinc chloride. It is a no need of, so anhydrous zinc chloride. So here no need of anhydrous zinc chloride means dehydrating agent. What is the reason? Directly tertiary butyl alcohol directly reacts with HCl, it can form tertiary butyl chloride. Tertiary butyl chloride. So directly it forms tertiary butyl chloride. What is the reason here? No need of anhydrous zinc chloride. Because it is a tertiary alcohol. So what is the character reactivity of that? So tertiary alcohols are more reactive than secondary or more reactive than primary. So due to high reactivity, so tertiary alcohol can easily react with HCl. So hence it has no need of anhydrous zinc chloride. So it is very important. So in the preparation of tertiary butyl chloride from tertiary butyl alcohol when treated with HCl, no need of catalyst because of high reactivity of, because of what is the reason? High reactivity of tertiary alcohol. High reactivity of tertiary alcohol. That is the reason. So it is the first method of preparation of ethyl chloride. Next, how we can prepare ethyl bromide and ethyl iodide. Ethyl bromide and ethyl iodide. Okay. So take the screenshot. Next. So by this method, how we can prepare ethyl bromide, ethyl chloride. So how we can prepare ethyl bromide and ethyl iodine. So ethyl alcohol, C2H5OH, C2H5OH reacts with either NaBr or KBr. In presence of concentrated sulfuric acid, concentrated sulfuric acid H2SO4 or 50% of HBr. So it gives C2H5Br. Ethyl bromide is formed. So in presence of sulfuric acid means, so here what are the byproducts? So C2H5Br. So here byproduct is sodium NaHSO4. Sodium bisulfate. This H plus ion is combined with OH. So water is also so ethyl bromide is formed. So what are the byproducts? Sodium bisulfate and what? If you take potassium bromide sulfuric acid, so ethyl bromide is formed. C2H5Br. And what are the byproducts? If you take sodium bromide, sodium bisulfate is the byproduct. If you take potassium bromide, potassium bisulfate, KHSO4 and water are the byproducts. Okay? So here sulfuric acid acts as dehydrating acid. So we can prepare iodides. So ethyl alcohol, C2H5OH, treated with potassium iodide. In the presence of nearly 95% of phosphoric acid, what is the formula of phosphoric acid? H3PO4. In this reaction, we cannot use sulfuric acid. Only phosphoric acid is preferable. Okay? So here it forms C2H5I ethyl iodide. Ethyl iodide is formed. So phosphoric acid is the phosphoric acid is preferable. So in this reaction, concentrated sulfuric acid cannot be used. So what is the reason? Only 95% of phosphoric acid is used, but not concentrated sulfuric acid. What is the reason? So sulfuric acid is the strong oxidizing agent. Nitric acid and sulfuric acid. So sulfuric acid is the oxidizing agent. So oxidizing nature is more for nitric acid. So this sulfuric acid also acts as oxidizing agent. So this sulfuric acid combined with Ki in the first step it forms hydrogen iodide. Finally, hydrogen iodide is converted to iodine. So your oxidation state of iodine is minus one. In a molecular state, oxidation state of iodine is zero. Hence, so sulfuric acid can convert Ki to HI, then it is converted to iodine. So, iodine does not react with ethyl alcohol. Hence, we use, instead of concentrated sulfuric acid, here we use phosphoric acid. Phosphoric acid is preferable. Because of sulfuric acid cannot be used in this reaction. So, what is the reason? Sulfuric acid can convert potassium iodide to hydrogen iodide and then finally it converts to iodine. Hence, in this reaction, instead of concentrated sulfuric acid, which is preferable, 95% of phosphoric acid is preferable. Okay, now the next one. Okay. So, first reagent is completed, HCl and zinc chloride. The next one. So, there's a mixture of anhydrous zinc chloride. HCl, concentrated HCl, I know, anhydrous zinc chloride is called, leucose reagent. So what is the leucose reagent? So mixture of anhydrous zinc chloride and concentrated HCl, it is called leucose reagent. Next, this method is called preparation of ethyl chloride from ethyl alcohol By using concentrated HCl and anhydrous glucuronate means by using a Lucas reagent, this method of preparation is called Grose process. It is called Grose process. So it is a main reaction. So mixture of what is Lucas reagent, it is very important. So what is Lucas reagent? A mixture of concentrated HCl and anhydrous zinc chloride mixture is called mixture of concentrated HCl and anhydrous zinc chloride is called Lucas reagent. Next, so method of preparation of ethyl chloride from ethyl alcohol by using Lucas reagent is called, what is the name of this method? Grose process. By Grose method, we can prepare ethyl chloride, means alkyl halides from alcohols. Okay, right. Next, from alcohols, what is the second reagent? From alcohols, so what is the second reagent? What is the second reagent from alcohol? So first one, alcohols reacts with Lucas reagent. First method, alcohols reacts with Lucas reagent, that is concentrated HCl and anhydrous zinc chloride. Ethyl chloride is formed, so it is Lucas reagent. This method is called Grose process. So it is called Grose process. Next, the second method. So alcohols treated with either PCl3 phosphorus trichloride or phosphorus pentachloride. These are the good chlorinating agents. So alcohols treated with either PCl3 or PCl4. This OH group is replaced by Cl. So it gives RCl. Next one, here byproduct is H3PO3 is the byproduct. So in this reaction, 3 moles of alcohol is involved and so 3 moles of alkyl chloride is involved. If you use PCl5, only 1 mole of alcohol reacts with 1 mole of PCl5. It gives alkyl chloride. Next one, PO Cl3 and HCl are the byproducts. POCl3 and HCl, phosphorus oxytrichloride or oxychloride and hydrogen chloride, these are the byproducts. So, alcohols treated with the second reagent, either PCl3 or PCl5. Take a specific example, ethyl alcohol, C2H5OH. Ethyl alcohol is treated with PCl3. In this reaction, 3 moles of ethyl alcohol reacts with 1 mole of PCl3. So, 3 OH groups are replaced by 3 chlorines. Here, 3 moles of ethyl chloride is formed C2H5Cl. Here, byproduct is POH taken thrice. It is not a base. OH means any OH is a base. Next one, KOH is a base. BaOH taken thrice is base. AlOH taken thrice, these are considered as bases. So POH taken thrice is not a base. It is considered as H3PO3. That is a phosphorus acid. You know the structure and basicity of a phosphorus acid in equivalent ways. So phosphorus acid basicity is 2. H3PO2. Phosphorus acid basicity is 2. Okay? Right. So, H3PO3, it is the byproduct. So, in the conversions, it is important. So, C2H5Cl and here X is formed. What is X? X is acid or base or salt. And what is the oxidation state of centralitin in X? What is the oxidation state of centralitin in X? And what is the basicity of X? It can form how many types of salts? Here, what is X? Here, X is phosphorus acid, H3PO3. So, it is acid or base? So, first one, it is acid. What is its basicity? So, basicity of this acid is, basicity of acid is 2. It can form how many types of salts? So, it is a dibasic acid and it forms 2 types of salts. It forms how many types of cells? Two types. Next, the fourth one, what is the oxidation state? Find the oxidation state. Hg3PO3, 3 hydrogens plus 3, phosphorus X, oxygen minus 2, for 3 oxygens, 3 into minus 2, that is minus 6, that equal to 0. So X minus 3 equal to 0, therefore X equal to plus 3. So what is the oxidation state of central atom in X? Plus 3 oxidation state. So it is acid, it is very basic acid, hence it forms two types of salts. And the oxidation state of central atom in X is a plus 3 oxidation state. Hybridization is a sp3 hybridization. Okay, ma'am? So these are the applications. So some byproducts are also important in organic chemistry. So here byproduct is Hg3PO3. Hg3PO3. So basic is a, here 3 moles of dialogol is used in this reaction, involved in this reaction. Second one, if you use the PCFR, just one mole reacts with one mole, it forms one mole of dichloride. POCl3 and HCl are the byproducts. POCl3 and HCl are the byproducts. So, by using this second method, means PCl3 and PCl5, can we prepare bromides and iodides? Can we prepare bromides and iodides? Is it possible or not? Or to prepare bromides, the reagent which is used, the reagent which is used. So by this method, to prepare bromides and iodides, use alcohol, C2H5OH, reacts with, so bromine reacts with, to prepare bromides, reacts with bromine, in the presence of red phosphorus, it is the it has a polymeric structure. So in the presence of red phosphorus, it gives C2H5PR. Here the purpose, bromine is reacts with red phosphorus. Here the compound formed is PBr3. Actually it is less stable. Hence we use mixture of red phosphorus and bromine. So to prepare iodine, C2H5OH reacts with iodine in the presence of red phosphorus. So ethyl iodide is formed, C2H5. So to prepare bromide, we use a mixture of bromine and red phosphorus. To prepare iodide, we use mixture of iodine and red phosphorus. Okay, so these are the methods of preparations of ethyl chloride or ethyl halides from ethyl alcohol. Next, so here third reagent is also used. Third reagent is thionyl chloride. So it is the last reaction, just half minute. So last reagent, third one, thionyl chloride. So what is the formula of thionyl chloride? What is the formula of thionyl chloride? Third method from alcohol. Alcohols reacts with thionyl chloride. SOCl2. In the presence of pyridine. C5H5N, pyridine. So here alkyl chloride is obtained. What are the byproducts? SO2 and HCl are the byproducts. HCl is acid. Sulfur dioxide is non-metal oxide. So what is the nature of sulfur dioxide? What is the nature of sulfur dioxide? Sulfur is non-metal. So it is a non-metal oxide. The nature of non-metal oxide is acidic. So it is also acidic impurity. HCl is also acidic impurity. The nature of pyridine. So pyridine acts as C5H5N acts as base. Because of it contains nitrogen. So it can remove this acidic impurity. So what is the role of pyridine? It can remove the acidic impurities. HCl and sulfur dioxide. So what is the role of pyridine in this reaction? So it can remove the acidic impurities. Pyridine can remove the acidic impurities, SO2 and HCl. Hence, in this method, pure alkyl halide is obtained. So to prepare pure alkyl halide, which reagent is suitable? hydrogen chloride, zinc chloride, or PCl3 or PCl5 or SOCl2 in pyridine, which is preferable. SOCl2 in presence of pyridine is preferable because of here acidic impurities, SO4-HCl removed by base, that is pyridine, and in this method pure ethyl halides are obtained. C2H5OH reacts with SOCl2 in the presence of pyridine. So ethyl chloride is obtained. C2H5Cl, and what are the impurities? HCl and SO2 are the byproducts. These two are absorbed or removed by pyridine. So because of pyridine has a basic nature. So in this method, pure ethyl chloride is obtained. So these are the methods of preparations of ethyl chloride from ethyl alcohol. So leucase 3 is in the Grose process, either PCl3 or PCl5. Next one, by using thionyl chloride in terms of pyridine. So we can discuss introduction, nomenclature, isomerism, classification, and up to preparation of ethyl chloride from alcohol only. Okay, right, thank you.